हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर नंद कुमार राव बोले फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग अंबाजोगाई इज गोइंग टू डील विथ अप्लाइड थर्मोडायनामिक्स 1. दिस इज आवर सिक्स्थ लेक्चर. नाउ टुडे प्रोसीडिंग टू द कंटेंट ऑफ प्रीवियस लेक्चर. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड हीट लॉसेस इन द बॉयलर प्लांट as well as heat balance sheet. So today we will be discussing numericals to find out equivalent evaporation, boiler efficiency and heat supplied by superheater to the steam. Then we will find out heat balance sheet for a problem. Coming to this problem, the following readings were taken during the test on a boiler for 1 hour. Tests were taken for 1 hour. So this data is given. Time duration is 1 hour. So here we will collect this given data. Given data, time duration is 1 hour. Then coming to next statement, steam generated is 5400 kg. That is nothing but mass of steam generated in 1 hour. So here this is mass of steam generated per hour. We can call 5400 kg per hour because this boiler is working for 1 hour. So this is mass of steam generated is 5400 kg per hour. Then next, coal burnt, mass of coal burned in 1 hour is 700 kg. So fuel burned, mass of fuel burned is 700 kg per hour. Then coming to calorific value of a fuel, if we burn 1 kg of fuel, then it liberates 31,500 kilojoules of energy. Calorific value of fuel is given as 31,500 kilojoules per kg. Then the dryness fraction of steam coming out of this boiler is also given. The steam which is coming out of boiler but it enters into the superheater with a dryness fraction of 0.92, that means it is X dryness fraction of steam. It is a wet steam before entering into the superheater. So dryness fraction is X is equal to 0.92, which is given. Then a rated pressure of boiler is 11.5 bar. So boiler working pressure is 11.5 bar, and this pressure is taken here. So rated pressure of boiler is 11.5 bar. Then the steam temperature when it comes out of the superheater is 250 degrees Celsius. The temperature of superheated steam T soup is 250 degrees Celsius. Then temperature of hot well, what this hot well is, it is nothing but a tank from which the feed water is supplied to the boiler. So this 45 degrees Celsius is temperature of feed water, 45 degrees Celsius. Then he is asking us to find out, determine equivalent evaporation per kg of fuel without and with superheater. So here two conditions are given. We have to find out equivalent evaporation considering steam as a wet steam and another steam as a superheated steam. Therefore, equivalent evaporation which we have to calculate is equivalent evaporation for wet steam, equivalent evaporation for superheated steam. And second, thermal efficiency of boiler, thermal efficiency of boiler without and with superheater. Again, boiler efficiency that we have to find out, if steam is wet and if steam is superheated, what will be the efficiency of a boiler. then amount of heat supplied by the superheater per hour to the steam. So as the steam is passed into the superheater, so heat is added to the steam, and that steam which is added in the superheater is known as actually heat added in superheater, not H soup, it is heat added in superheater. First column is given data, second column what we are supposed to find out. Now first of all, before solving a problem, we will make a plan to solve this problem. See here, equivalent evaporation, to find out equivalent evaporation we have a formula, H minus H feed divided by HFG, that is latent heat of vaporization, which is 2256.9 into M. This M is nothing but ratio of mass of steam to mass of fuel, MS divided by MF. So this is the equation which helps us to find out equivalent evaporation. Now second equation to find out boiler efficiency, boiler efficiency is equal to H minus H feed, where H is the enthalpy of steam coming out of the boiler and H feed is the enthalpy of water which is entering into the boiler, and CV is calorific value of fuel, and again M is nothing but ratio of mass of steam to the mass of fuel per unit time. Here M is nothing but mass of steam in kilo kg per hour, and MF is mass of fuel burned in kg per hour. Now here what is asked in this problem, equivalent evaporation if steam is wet, equivalent evaporation if steam is superheated. So here H is nothing but enthalpy of steam. Here we are going to take steam in two different qualities, wet steam and superheated steam. So enthalpy of steam is nothing but, once we have to find out enthalpy of wet steam and once we have to find out enthalpy of superheated steam. Therefore we find here two equations. If steam is wet, then to find out enthalpy of wet steam we use this formula HF plus XHFG. So this is the enthalpy of wet steam. Then to find out enthalpy of superheated steam is nothing but HF plus HFG plus CPS, it is not CPG, it is CPS into T soup minus TS, where T soup is temperature of superheated steam and TS is a saturation temperature. So by using these two formulae we find out enthalpy of wet steam, enthalpy of superheated steam, and here enthalpy of feed water that we have to find out, which is equal to H feed is equal to enthalpy of feed water is equal to CPW, specific heat of water, into TF minus T0. TF is temperature of feed water and T0 is zero temperature of water. So this is how we have to start to solve this problem. So first of all, in order to find out equivalent evaporation, we must find enthalpy of wet steam and enthalpy of superheated steam. To know enthalpy of wet steam and enthalpy of superheated steam, we must collect the enthalpies HF, HFG from steam table. So we have to move to the steam table and we have to collect this data. So from steam table, at a pressure of 11.5 bar, we can get enthalpy of water, that is HF, 789.9 kilojoules per kg. Then latent heat, that is 1991.4 kilojoules per kg. Then HG, enthalpy of dry saturated steam, 2781.3 kilojoules per kg. And TS is saturation temperature at 11.5 bar. So now very first, in previous equation, mass ratio M is equal to MS divided by MF. So mass of steam is nothing but 5400 kg per hour and mass of fuel is 700 kg per hour. So coming to this calculation, so this is mass of steam is equal to 5400 5400 kg per hour and mass of fuel is 700 kg per hour, and if we calculate this, this will work out to be 7.71 kg per kg of fuel. Kg per kg of fuel. So if we discuss about the units, unit of mass of steam is kg per hour, and mass of fuel burned is kg per hour. So this hour gets cancelled. This kg of steam, in numerator it is kg of steam, and in denominator it is kg of fuel. So unit which remains is kg of steam. Per kg of fuel. Then coming to next, enthalpy of feed water. So specific heat of water that is known to us, which is 4.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin, 4.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin into temperature of feed water, which is given in our problem itself. If we see, temperature of feed water is, here it is given, 45 degree Celsius. So 45 minus T0 is 0. So if we calculate this, this works out to be 184.5 kilojoules per kg. This is enthalpy of feed water. Then coming to enthalpy of wet steam. Enthalpy of wet steam is nothing but hf plus xhfg. So already we know hf value, which is 789.9 plus dryness fraction, which is given in the problem, is 0.92. You can see here dryness fraction is 0.92. So this dryness fraction we have copied into HFG, enthalpy latent heat of vaporization, which is given here 1991. We have obtained it from steam table at 11.5 bar. So 1991.4. And if we calculate this enthalpy of wet steam, it works out to be 2621.98 kilojoules per kg. And coming to enthalpy of superheated steam. First we have to find out enthalpy of wet steam, then when enthalpy of superheated steam, because we want to find out equivalent evaporation if steam is wet and if steam is superheated. HF value is 789.9 plus HFG, which is 1991.4, plus specific heat of water or steam, which we say is 2.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin, into temperature of superheated steam, which is given in this problem. Temperature of superheated steam is 250 degree Celsius. 250 degree Celsius minus saturation temperature at pressure of 11.5 bar, which is given here, is 186 degree Celsius. 186 degree Celsius. And if we simplify this, we get enthalpy of superheated steam as 2915 2915.7 kilojoules per kg. So now we are ready with the material to find out equivalent evaporation. Now coming to next, what we have to do is we have to find out equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency for wet steam and for superheated steam. So now equivalent evaporation of wet steam is given by mass of steam generated per unit mass of fuel burned m into h wet, enthalpy of wet steam minus enthalpy of feed water divided by 2256. So m value which we have calculated is 7.71 into enthalpy of wet steam that we have calculated. H wet is equal to 2621.9898 minus enthalpy of feed water. Enthalpy of feed water which we have obtained is 184.5 kilojoules. 184.5 kilojoules minus 184.5, close this bracket, divided by 2256.9, and further simplifying this we will get equivalent evaporation of wet steam as 8.32 kg of steam per kg of fuel. This is equivalent evaporation for wet steam. In the similar way, we have to find out equivalent evaporation for superheated steam. Mass is known, that is 7.71 kg of steam per kg of fuel burned. Enthalpy of superheated steam which we have calculated as 2915.7 minus enthalpy of feed water which is 184.5. earlier this we have used 184, same thing we will write here, divided by 2256.9. so on further simplification we get if equivalent evaporation of superheated steam as 9.33 kg of steam per kg of fuel. So this is how we obtained equivalent evaporation for wet steam and equivalent evaporation for wet steam and this is equivalent evaporation for superheated steam. Now coming to the boiler efficiency, mass of steam generated per kg of fuel burned is 7.71 into enthalpy of wet steam which we have calculated as 2621.98 minus enthalpy of feed water is 184.5 divided by calorific value of fuel which is given in the problem as 31,500 kilojoules per kg. So here we will be writing this 31,500 kilojoules of heat energy is liberated by combustion of 1 kg of fuel. So on simplifying this, we get into 100. This is efficiency multiplied by 100. Then we will get efficiency in percentage. Efficiency we will be getting as 59.66%. Then coming to the efficiency of boiler using superheated steam. So mass of steam generated per kg of fuel, that is known as 7.71, which we have calculated as the ratio of ms divided by mf. Then enthalpy of superheated steam, which was calculated as 2915.7 minus enthalpy of feed water, is calculated as 184.5 kilojoules per kg, and calorific value of fuel that we know is 31,500 multiplied by 100. This gives us percentage efficiency of boiler if steam used is superheated, and on calculation or on simplification we get this as 66.84%. So this is how we have obtained boiler efficiency. If wet steam is used, this is 59.66, and if steam is superheated, boiler efficiency is 66.84. So by using a superheater, definitely efficiency of a boiler is going to enhance or increase. Then one more thing is asked: amount of heat added in the superheater, heat supplied in the superheater. So before entering into the superheater, steam is wet, so amount of heat of this enthalpy of steam entering into the superheater is h wet, and enthalpy of steam leaving the superheater is h soup. And how much amount of steam is entering into this superheater is nothing but ms. So knowing this h soup and h wet, we can find out amount of enthalpy added per kg, and multiplied by mass of steam we will get amount of heat energy added per hour. So this mass of steam is in having unit kg per hour. So enthalpy of superheated steam, which we have calculated as 2915.7 minus enthalpy of wet steam is 2621.98 into mass of steam is 5400 kg per kg of fuel burned. So this, if we simplify, works out to be 15.86. into 10 to the power of 5 kilojoules per hour. So this unit, how we get kilojoules per hour? Enthalpy of steam is given in kilojoules per kg, and amount of steam produced is in kg per hour. Kg kg gets cancelled, so remaining unit is kilojoules per hour. So this is amount of heat supplied in the superheater, Q superheater. So now once we have solved, it is our duty to write the answers in systematic way. So what is asked in bit A, equivalent evaporation with superheater is 9.33, which we have obtained. Equivalent evaporation with superheater is 9.33, and without superheater it is 8.32. it is 8.32. Boiler efficiency which we obtained is 59.66 without superheater and 66.84 with superheater. If we see here, without superheater it is, with superheater it is 66.84, and with without superheater it is 59.66. amount of heat supplied in the superheater is 15.8652 into 10 to the power 5 kilojoules per hour, which we have calculated here. 15.86 into 10 to the power of 9 kilojoules per hour. This is how we have solved one problem in which we have obtained equivalent operation with superheater, without superheater, and boiler efficiency with superheater, without superheater, and amount of heat added in the superheater. Coming to the next problem, just I will read out this second problem and we'll extract data, and what is to be done in this problem we'll discuss. So now coming to this, following observations made in a boiler trial, coal used 250 kg and calorific value is 29,800 kilojoules per hour. Water evaporated is 200 kg. So coal used, mass of fuel used is 250 kg. So here nothing is given about the time duration. So we have to assume time as 1 hour, so 250 kg per hour. Then calorific value of fuel is 29,800. So calorific value of fuel is 29,800 kilojoules per kg. Then water evaporated is 200 kg. That means whatever amount is evaporated, water is supplied, is nothing but evaporated, and that is nothing but amount of steam generated. 200 kg per hour steam is generated. The working pressure of steam is 11.5 bar, so P is equal to 11.5 bar. Dryness fraction of steam is 0.95. X value is given, 0.95. Feed water temperature, the temperature of water entering into the boiler is 34 degrees Celsius, so temperature of feed water is 34 degrees Celsius. Calculate equivalent evaporation from and at 100 degree Celsius per kg of coal. The efficiency of boiler and the efficiency of boiler, so we have to find out equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency, two things we have to find out. Now here the equivalent evaporation is obtained by this equation. Equivalent evaporation is equal to mass of steam generated per kg of fuel. So here already it is asked, per kg of coal is asked, so mass of steam generated per kg of coal, and H minus H feed, where H is enthalpy of steam leaving the boiler and H feed is the enthalpy of water entering into the boiler, and this is a constant latent heat of vaporization at atmospheric pressure. Then boiler efficiency can be obtained by this equation. Boiler efficiency is obtained by second equation, M into H minus H feed divided by CV, calorific value into 100, and this mass M is nothing but mass of steam generated. mass of steam generated is ms divided by mf, mass of fuel used per hour, and h is the enthalpy of steam leaving. Steam is wet, so this we can call as a h wet, h plus of x hfg, where x is the dryness fraction, and h feed is the enthalpy of feed water into cpw, specific heat of water, into tf minus t0. So from this we have to find out the efficiency. So in order to start with solution, so we have to go in reverse away. So first of all, we must find out enthalpy of wet steam, enthalpy of feed water. So to know this, first we must know hf and hfg from steam table, and then we can find out h wet and h feed. M we can find out, then we can find out equivalent operation and boiler efficiency. So simplification will be starting from bottom to top. So this is our requirement. While writing equations, we start to write equations from top to bottom, but while solving problem, we start from bottom to top. So now at 11.5 bar from steam table, we get enthalpy of water as 789.9 kilojoules per kg, latent heat of vaporization at 11.5 bar 1991.4. This hf is enthalpy of saturated water, hfg is nothing but latent heat of vaporization, and this hg 2781.3 kilojoules per kg is enthalpy of dry saturated steam, and saturation temperature of steam, dry saturated steam, is 186.0. then we find out m ratio, mass of steam evaporated divided by mass of fuel burned per unit time. So here it is given mf is 250, mass of fuel burned is 250, and mass of steam is 200 kg. 200 divided by 250, on calculation we get this as 0.8 kg of steam is produced per kg of fuel burnt. Then after that we find out h feed, enthalpy of feed water. So specific heat of water is 4.1 into temperature of feed water, which is given in the problem as 34 degrees Celsius. 34 degree Celsius is temperature of feed water, 34 minus T0 is 0. So on calculation, this we get as 184.5. Then we have to find out enthalpy of wet steam, H wet. Find out enthalpy of wet steam, HF, which is taken from steam table as 789.9 plus dryness fraction X, which is given in the problem as 0.95, which is given here as 0.95, into HFG as 1991.4, which is obtained from steam table. And on simplification, enthalpy of wet steam, H wet, we get as 2681.73 kilojoules per kg. And coming to equivalent evaporation of wet steam, m is known, that is 0.8, which we have obtained here. m is the ratio of mass of steam to the mass of fuel burned, which is 0.8 into enthalpy of wet steam. This h is nothing but enthalpy of wet steam, h wet, which we have calculated as 2681.73 minus enthalpy of feed water is 184.5. whole divided by constant is given here 2256.9, and on calculation this equivalent evaporation is 0.9 kg of steam per kg of coal burned. Then coming to the boiler efficiency, mass of steam generated per kg of fuel, that is known, which is 0.8 into enthalpy of wet steam, that is 2681.73 minus enthalpy of feed water is 184.5, whole divided by calorific value of fuel, which is given in the problem as 29,800 kilojoules per kg. Calorific value is given 29,800 kilojoules per kg of fuel. On simplification into 100, we are finding efficiency. So to find out efficiency in percentage, we have to multiply it by 100. Efficiency works out to be 66.82%. 6.82% only. So this is how we have obtained equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency. Finally, we have to write answers in systematic way. Equivalent evaporation is 0.9 kg of steam per kg of fuel, and boiler efficiency is 6.82%. Maybe some data may be wrong. Answer which is shown is very small. The efficiency is very low. So this is how we solve the problem in systematic way. Now coming to the next problem. This problem helps us to find out equivalent evaporation boiler efficiency as well as to find out boiler heat balance sheet of a boiler. So now looking at this problem, the following observations were recorded during a trial on boiler. So this problem includes three sets. One is as similar to the previous problem, to find out equivalent evaporation boiler efficiency. Then second, the dryness fraction x value which was given in the previous problem is not given directly here. So instead of giving dryness fraction here, he has given data related with the throttling calorimeter, and using that data we have to find out dryness fraction x. Third part is to find out heat balance sheet. So now here the data given, we will read mass of feed water and its temperature. Mass of feed water means mass of steam generated. This is ms is 640 kg per hour, and temperature of feed water tf is 50 degrees Celsius, and pressure of steam p, which is given here as 10 bar. Just I will change color here. So mass of steam is 640, temperature of feed water is 50 degrees Celsius, pressure of steam is 10 bar. Then fuel used, mass of fuel burned, MF is equal to 55 kg per hour. Then calorific value, higher calorific value CV is 44,100 kilojoules per kg. temperature of gases Tg, temperature of hot gases which are liberated is 300 degree Celsius, the gases which are liberated into the atmosphere. Then boiler room temperature, temperature of boiler room, T boiler house, is given. So we'll collect this data in table. Then coming to next information. For finding dryness fraction. So here clearly he has mentioned you have to find out dryness fraction of steam. Steam is passed through the throttling calorimeter. Steam is passed through throttling calorimeter and following observations were noted. The temperature of steam is 120 degree Celsius. Pressure of steam is 5 centimeter of Hg above atmosphere. The temperature of steam coming out of this calorimeter, temperature of steam, when steam is passed through the throttling calorimeter, its quality is going to enhance. Initially, when steam is passed into the throttling calorimeter, it is assumed to be wet steam, and when steam comes out, that becomes superheated. As the temperature of steam is given, steam is coming out in the form of superheated steam, and pressure of steam at the outlet of throttling calorimeter is 5 centimeters of Hg above atmosphere, means this is a gauge pressure, P gauge, above atmospheric pressure. This indicates it is a gauge pressure, it is not absolute pressure. And barometer reading is 762 mm of Hg, means it is atmospheric pressure. In centimeters it will be 76.2 mm of Hg. And then heating surface of boiler is 18.6 meter square. Then specific heat of gases is 1.1 kilojoules per kg. Specific heat of superheated steam is given as 2.1 kilojoules per kg. The composition of oil used. Oil is used as a fuel. Oil is used as a fuel, and composition of that fuel is 85% is carbon, 13% is hydrogen, and remaining is ash. How much is the percentage of ash? Then if we find out, this is 98, means 2% is the ash. The flue gas analysis by volume. So gases which are evolved by the combustion of fuel are analyzed using ORSAT apparatus, and this analysis tells us that there is a carbon dioxide which is 12.5%, oxygen 4.5%, and nitrogen 83%. There is no carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is absent. This indicates that the combustion of fuel is complete. Incomplete combustion has not taken place, means complete heat energy which 1 kg of fuel has to liberate, calorific value is 44,100 kilojoules per kg, is liberated. No fuel is incompletely burned because there is no carbon monoxide in the flue gases. Compositions of flue gases contain carbon dioxide, oxygen and nitrogen. Here sufficient oxygen is supplied, therefore oxygen is also coming out of this furnace without reacting. Now then he is asking us to find out equivalent evaporation per kg of fuel and per meter square of heating surface per hour. Equivalent evaporation is asked. So usually equivalent evaporation is given in kg of steam per kg of fuel, or in kg of steam per unit time. So this is something misleading. This was supposed to be asked for evaporation rate. So this is confusing. Only we have to find out equivalent evaporation per kg of fuel, and even if he wants, he has to ask equivalent evaporation per hour, in kg per hour. Then boiler efficiency, also draw heat balance sheet on 1 kg of fuel basis. So assuming that 1 kg of fuel is burned, how much amount of heat energy is generated and how much amount of heat energy is utilized in various heat losses, that we have to find out. Then steam partial pressure of steam which is produced in the combustion chamber due to combustion of hydrogen is 0.7 bar. So this is the information given in problem. So this information is collected in this table. Mass of steam generated is 640 kg per hour. Mass of fuel burned is 55 kg per hour. Temperature of feed water is 50 degree Celsius. Pressure of boiler or steam is 10 bar. Then calorific value of fuel is 44,100. Temperature of gases liberated in the atmosphere is 300. Temperature of boiler house is 30 degree Celsius. Atmospheric pressure is 762 mm of Hg. Heating surface area, which is 18.6 meter square. Specific heat of gas is 1.1. Then specific heat of steam is 2.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. Then data related to throttling calorimeter. Temperature of steam coming out of throttling calorimeter is 120 degree Celsius. And pressure of steam coming out of this throttling calorimeter is 5 centimeters of Hg above atmospheric pressure. Then the composition of fuel is given. Composition of fuel by mass. 1 kg of fuel contains 85%. 85% means if we are going to burn 1 kg of fuel, only 85.85 kg is the carbon in 1 kg of fuel. Remaining contents are something different. Hydrogen is 13%. 13% means 0.13 kg contains hydrogen. And 0.02 kg is fuel. So earlier I told that it is 2%. It is 2% means 0.02 kg per kg of fuel. Then flue gas analysis by volume, which indicates no carbon monoxide. Nothing is mentioned. And carbon dioxide is 12.5%. Oxygen is 4.5%, nitrogen is 83%, and steam partial pressure is 0.7 bar. What is asked in this? He is asking us to find out equivalent evaporation. Then equivalent evaporation, only using superheated steam, or even we can find out using wet steam also. Equivalent evaporation, then boiler efficiency, then heat supplied by combustion of fuel, 1 kg of fuel, then Q1, amount of heat used by steam, then amount of heat carried by flue gases, amount of heat carried by flue gases, Q2, then Q3, amount of heat lost due to unburned fuel, and Q4, unaccounted heat losses. Then coming to solution, equivalent evaporation can be obtained by this formula. Equivalent evaporation is equal to m h minus h feed divided by 2257. So it was actually 22.5 something 97. So we are going to find out equivalent evaporation using this formula. Then boiler efficiency, then mass of steam generated per kg of fuel, then enthalpy of feed water, the enthalpy of wet steam. So to find out enthalpy of wet steam, we must find out x dryness fraction, which is not given in the problem. In order to find out x dryness fraction, we must simplify the formula, or we must do some efforts to find out the equation enthalpy before throttling is equal to enthalpy after throttling. Enthalpy before throttling at pressure 10 bar, steam pressure is 10 bar, and enthalpy after throttling when steam pressure is 5 centimeters of Hg above atmosphere. So enthalpy of steam before throttling is given by hf plus x hfg, and enthalpy of steam after throttling is given by hf plus hfg plus cps t sup minus ts, because steam coming out of this is superheated steam. So now we have to convert this pressure 5 centimeters of hg above atmospheric into absolute pressure. So to convert this, 76.2 centimeters is the atmospheric pressure plus 5 centimeters is the gauge pressure, so total is 81.2 centimeters of hg. So this pressure has to be converted into bar again, because properties of steam after throttling must be obtained, and from steam table, if we want to obtain collect these properties, we must see steam table in bar. So therefore that is to be converted into bar. Then heat balance sheet. In this heat balance sheet, we have to find out here mass of fuel is assumed as 1 kg. Then amount of heat generated, actually QS, amount of heat supplied is equal to mass of fuel into CV. But here mass of fuel is assumed as 1 kg, therefore QS is equal to CV. Then amount of heat utilized by steam, that is Q1, is equal to M into H into H feed. M into H minus H feed. M is nothing but mass of steam generated per kg of fuel. Then Q2 is amount of heat carried by hot gases into the atmosphere, Mg CpG into Tg minus Ta, where Tg is temperature of hot gases, Ta is temperature of ambient air, then or ambient air or air entering into the furnace. Then Mg is the mass of hot gases produced. So to find out mass of hot gases is nothing but sum of air and sum of carbon in the fuel. So here mass of air required for combustion is obtained by Nc, N minus C divided by 33 into CO plus CO2. So this, how we get this equation, we will be discussing in the next chapter, that is combustion of fuel. In case of combustion of fuel, we will be discussing about this. Now after that, amount of heat carried by steam produced by combustion of hydrogen is given by MS1. This MS1 is the amount of water produced by combustion of hydrogen present in the fuel. Hg is the enthalpy of steam, and HF1 is the enthalpy of water at the boiler house temperature. So mass of steam produced by combustion of hydrogen is given by percentage of hydrogen into 9. Then Hg1 we have to obtain at 0.07 bar. So this will be the pressure after converting the pressure from centimeters of Hg into bar. So that we will be converting. Hg is the enthalpy of dry saturated steam, then CPS is the specific heat, then T sup temperature of steam which is in the hot gases, and TS is the temperature of steam saturation at 0.07 bar. Then enthalpy HF1 is the enthalpy of water produced in the combustion chamber, which is given by CPW into boiler house temperature minus of T0. Then unaccounted heat Q4 is equal to total amount of heat supplied minus various heats used Q1, Q2 and Q3. Now coming to next thing, that is to find out enthalpies, we must find out dryness fraction. So first we will be focusing on finding the dryness fraction of steam coming out of this boiler. So enthalpy before throttling at 10 bar is equal to enthalpy after throttling at 5 centimeters of Hg. So 5 centimeters of Hg has to be converted. So to find out enthalpy of wet steam, we write formula HF plus X HFG at 10 bar. Steam is wet, and after throttling steam is going to become superheated. That is obtained, enthalpy of superheated steam is obtained as HF plus HFG plus CPS into T sup minus TS at 5 centimeters of Hg gauge pressure, which is given at the exit of throttling calorimeter. So first of all, to find out X, we can find out HF, HFG at 10 bar, but this HF after throttling, HFG after throttling cannot be obtained at 5 centimeters of Hg because steam tables are provided in bar. So therefore pressure has to be converted into bar. So absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. So atmospheric pressure, which is given as in this problem, it is 76.2 plus gauge pressure is 5 centimeters. So this works out to be 81.2 centimeter of Hg, or this can be written as 0.812 meters of Hg. Now to convert this into bar, formula is rho gh. Rho of density of mercury is 13,600 into acceleration due to gravity is 9.81, and this h is nothing but pressure in meters of Hg, which is 0.812. On simplification, we get this as 1.08 into 10 to the power of 5 into 10 to the power of minus 5. To convert this into bar, so this we are going to get. So if we want to write, this will be in Newton per meter square. So 10 to the power of 5 Newton per meter square is equal to 1 bar. So this, if we replace by bar, so pressure is 1.08 bar. 1.08 bar. Now we can get this information at 10 bar before throttling. At 10 bar, enthalpy of saturated water is 762 and enthalpy of vaporization, latent heat of vaporization, is 2013.6 kilojoules per kg. So this we can take at 10 bar. So from steam table, at pressure which we have calculated at 1.08 bar, we get this Hg. Hg is nothing but sum of HF plus HFG, and that is nothing but 2679.6. Already this is available in steam table. Temperature of saturation at 1.08 bar is 102.32 degree Celsius. Specific heat of steam that we know, which is 2.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin, and temperature of superheated steam is 120 degree Celsius. So HF we know before throttling. So we change this color. So enthalpy of saturated water at 10 bar is 762.6 plus dryness fraction that we don't know. We are going to find out this dryness fraction into HFG at 10 bar is 2013. 0.6, which is equal to HF plus HFG. This total is obtained here. Sum of this is 2679.6 plus specific heat of steam is 2.1 into temperature of superheated steam in the vapor, or sorry, in the hot gases is steam after throttling is 120 degrees Celsius minus saturation temperature is 102.32. So this 120 is given in problem itself. Steam after throttling, temperature of steam after throttling is 120, specific heat of steam is 2.1. everything is given, so that data we are going to substitute here. On simplification, the value of X dryness fraction we are going to obtain as 0.97. Now coming to this mass of steam per kg of fuel burned. So mass of steam which is produced per hour is 640. 640 mass of fuel burned per kg is 55 kg per hour. So we will be substituting it here. 640 divided by 55. On simplification, this M will be 11.63 kg of steam per kg of fuel. Then enthalpy of feed water is equal to CPW, specific heat of water is 4.1, into temperature of feed water which is given in the problem, 50 degree Celsius. Temperature of feed water is 50 degree Celsius. -0. Enthalpy of feed water 210 kilojoules per kg of steam. Then enthalpy of wet steam, HF we know, which is given in the steam table. HF is 762.6, which is obtained from steam table. 762.6 plus dryness fraction which we have obtained just now is 0.97. into HFG value which is taken from steam table at 10 bar is 2013.6. Now in calculation we get this as enthalpy of steam is 2715.79 kilojoules per kg. To find out equivalent evaporation is given by ME is equal to M into H minus HP divided by 2257. So mass of fuel ratio which we have obtained, MF divided by MS, is 11.63 into enthalpy of wet steam is 2700 15.79 minus enthalpy of feed water is 210 kilojoules per kg whole divided by 2257. Now on simplification, this equivalent evaporation will be 12.9 kg of steam per kg of fuel. Then coming to boiler efficiency, boiler efficiency is given by this equation. Mass is known, 11.63 into h is 2715.79 minus enthalpy of feed water is 210 kilojoules per kg whole divided by calorific value of fuel, which is given in the problem, 44,100 kilojoules per kg divided by 44,100 on simplification into 100. This is efficiency, we have to find out in percentage. So this is equal to 66.2%. Then coming to heat balance, the heat amount of heat produced by combustion of fuel is actually mf into cv, but per kg of fuel we are going to take here. Mass of fuel is taken as 1, so calorific value of fuel is 44,100 kilojoules per kg. So this is in kilojoules, this much amount of heat energy is produced by combustion of 1 kg of fuel. Then coming to next, Q1, amount of heat utilized by steam per kg of fuel burned. So this is nothing but m into h minus h feed at 10 bar. Mass of steam produced per kg of fuel, m is 11 point, so how much it was calculated, 11.63 into h, enthalpy of wet steam, which we obtained as enthalpy of wet steam 2715.79 minus enthalpy of feed water, which we obtained here as 210 kilojoules per kg, 210. On simplification, we get this is the amount of heat utilized by water to convert into steam, 29,158 kilojoules of heat is used by water to get converted into steam. So now to find out heat carried by flue gases, we must know mass of flue gases, specific heat is known, temperature of hot gases is known, temperature of ambient air is also known. Only what is not known is mass of hot gases. Mass of hot gases is sum of mass of air supplied for combustion plus mass of carbon present in the fuel. So here mass of air first we must know, then mass of carbon already, which is given in the problem. So mass of air supplied is given by this formula, N into C divided by 33 into CO plus CO2. N, percentage of nitrogen is 83 in the fuel, which is given in the problem. So here N N is flue gases. Flue gas analysis shows that 83% is nitrogen. Then carbon percentage is 85 in the fuel. So this is 85, 83, 85. So N is 83, C is 85%, whole divided by 33 into carbon monoxide is not present, it is absent, so 0 plus percentage of carbon dioxide is 12.5%, which is given in the problem. Just we'll see here, percentage of carbon dioxide is 12.5%. Therefore, on simplification, we get this mass of air as 17.1 kg of air is required. So, mass of hot gases produced is 17.1 kg plus mass of carbon present. Say, for example, 85% is carbon. If we are going to burn 1 kg means 1000 gram, so 850 grams will be carbon. In kg it will be 0.85 kg of carbon. So here 0.85 we have to write, as we are going to burn only 1 kg of fuel and that contains only 0.85 kg of carbon. So mass of hot gases which are produced will be 17.95 kg per kg of fuel burned. If we burn 1 kg of fuel, then 17.95 kg of hot gases are produced. So now coming back to calculation of heat, we know mass of gases produced, just now we have calculated as 17.95. Into specific heat of hot gases, which is given in the problem, Cp g, it is 1.1. 1.1 is specific heat of hot gases, which is given. 1.1 into Tg, temperature of hot gases, is 300, I think. Temperature of flue gases is given as 300. Boiler house temperature is 30. Temperature of hot gases is 300 degrees Celsius. Minus Ta is the boiler house temperature. So this is 30, already temperature is 30. So if we simplify this, we get 5331.15 kilojoules of heat is carried along with the flue gases. So this is amount of heat supplied QS. This is amount of heat utilized by water to convert into steam, and this is Q2, heat carried by hot gases in the atmosphere. Then heat carried by moisture in gases per kg of fuel. So to find out heat carried by moisture, Q3 is equal to MS1, mass of moisture into enthalpy of steam and enthalpy of water produced in the combustion chamber. So first of all, we must know mass of steam produced. So moisture formed per kg of fuel is obtained by percentage of hydrogen into 9. So if we multiply, percentage of hydrogen is 13, that means 0.13 into 9. So this works out 1.17 kg. 1.17 kg is the moisture formed in the flue gases. The mass of flue gas was actually 17.98. So this contains 1.17 kg of moisture. Then mass of moisture is known, Hg. Steam which is obtained there, it is a dry saturated steam, sorry, superheated steam. So to find out temperature of superheated steam at 0.07 bar, so it was given in this problem itself, the temperature, partial pressure of steam in this combustion chamber, which is given the problem. Partial pressure of steam is 0.07 bar. So data is taken at 0.07 bar from steam table. So at 0.07 bar, enthalpy of dry saturated steam is given. Then saturation temperature is also given in the steam table. So this data is taken from steam table. Mass of steam is known, Hg is known, CPS, specific heat of steam is known, temperature of superheated steam and temperature of saturation is known. Then HF, so this is the enthalpy of water produced in the boiler house that we have to find out here. So HF is equal to CPW just for a minute. HF is equal to CPW. CPW is specific heat of water is 4.1 into boiler house temperature is 30 degree Celsius minus T0 is 0.
123.0 kilojoules. 123 kilojoules. So now coming back to this, mass of steam we know 1.17 into Hg is 2572 at 0.07 bar, 2572.6 plus CPS, specific heat of steam, which is 2.1 into temperature of superheated steam. Here superheated steam is produced when steam is heated up to 300 degree Celsius. It is at temperature of gas which is exhausted minus temperature of saturation 39 degree Celsius, which is obtained from steam table at 0.07 bar, minus HF which is obtained as 123, and on calculation we get Q3 as 3504 kilojoules per kg of fuel burnt. Next, coming to unaccounted heat, heat lost by convection, Q4 is equal to total amount of heat supplied, Qs which we have obtained as 44,100 minus Q1 amount of heat absorbed by steam is 29,158 plus Q2 amount of heat, Q2 is the amount of heat carried by flue gases, which is 5,331.15 0.9 से प्लस Q3 which we have obtained is 3504. So on simplification we get this as 6107 kilojoules. So amount of heat supplied that we have obtained is 44100. By combustion of 1 kg of fuel, 44,100 kilojoules is supplied, heat is supplied. So out of that, Q1 is utilized to generate steam. So amount of steam used to generate steam is 29,158 out of 44,100. In percentage, how much percentage of heat is utilized to generate steam is obtained here. This is 66.12% amount of heat is utilized to generate steam. Then heat carried by flue gases, Q2 is 5331.9 divided by 44,100 into 100. Percentage of heat utilized to heat carried by flue gases is 12.10%. And next is Q3, heat carried by moisture in gases, 3504 divided by 44,100 into 100. This is equal to 7.96% heat is carried by moisture, and unaccounted heat is 6107 divided by 44,100 into 100. So this is equal to 13.28. Percentage of heat is unaccounted or which is lost by convection and radiation. So coming to this, we have to write this answer. Equivalent evaporation which we have obtained is 12.9 kg per kg of steam. Boiler efficiency which we have obtained is 66.2%, and amount of heat supplied is 44,100 kilojoules. Amount of heat used to generate steam is percentage of heat used to generate steam is 66.12%. And amount of heat carried by flue gases is 12.10%, then heat carried by moisture is 7.96%, unaccounted heat is 13.28%. So this is known as a heat balance. So if we add amount of heats 66, 12, 7 and 13, so this must be equal to 100%. So this is how we are going to find out heat balance, equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency. I hope you have followed. Now I request you all to take pen and paper and simultaneously do the calculations. This is the procedure to obtain heat balance sheet. Thank you.